actually sit with your legs that way. Yeah, so they can see over. All right, guys, so right now, I did the left. You can see, well, maybe you can't, but this one's higher up, this one's lower. Now I'm gonna use my poker to release the traps.
Probably the worst part.
No, it goes, if you have a trigger point in your traps, it'll go to your,
Should I be
straight? Just chill the fuck out and let me do my thing.
I'm scared.
Stop being scared. So, trigger points are little pimples that develop inside the muscle from overuse or injury. And there's so much stuff that surrounds the muscle that you have to be able to break through all that other stuff to get in there. And there's an actual trigger point, different than pressure point, trigger point chart that you can follow. There's three trigger points back here, but so I use my poker and the traps to get deep down into the muscle. And then when I'm down, I hold for 15 seconds. So the hold is very important, guys. So once I decide where to stop from pressing, I'm gonna hold. Yeah. So why the 15 seconds? Because the doctors that discovered the trigger points, Dr. Janet Travell and David Simmons, 1942, they discovered that this is what goes on in muscle malfunction, right? The trigger points. So they made a chart and they determined through their research that it takes about 15 seconds on a hold to release a trigger point. So, and you gotta apply pressure. Feel better?
Yeah.
And sometimes, oh my God, my hair's like all to my side. Like, hey, I need somebody to style my dreads once a week. I really do. Anybody that can come and style my dreads for me, we can work out a session thing. But. I need some help!
I need some help.
I got you! Relax your arms. And yeah, so you want to slouch. You don't have to perch up. So I'm going to stand up.
Right here.
You're good. And it's all about angles. How you work on somebody and how you can get to the point that you need to get to. I got to stand up on the table so I can have a direct straight attack into her chest. There we go. You feel like... One of them.
Well, that's the third I like. Mm-hmm. I
So also an active trigger point causes referral pain to another area. So if you guys want to research trigger point therapy, trigger points, there are charts online. The manual that I studied from, there's two volumes that I studied from. Those are intense scientific manuals, but I enjoyed them, learning about it. An active trigger point will cause a referral pain. So sometimes there aren't active trigger points. If you look at our chart and say, oh, there should be some here, but they may not be active. So that's a good thing. Sometimes it's just the buildup of fascia, the stagnant of the blood, the stagnant of the acid. It's not always a trigger point. And that's why I use different modalities. And I guarantee you, if you go to any doctor, chiropractor, or acupuncturist, and you say, I have neck pain, they're gonna tell you about your disc being herniated. And that, discs are movable, so maybe it is, but that's not the problem. Now, you gotta really know what you're doing when you're using a tool like this or going this deep into muscle. Cause you can do damage. Hold on, honey. You're good. Better?
I felt that like...
Open it all up. Okay, down. I'm gonna do this side now. So I haven't even started my guacha on this side or anything, but I'm just gonna go over here and start to release the traps. If I were to guacha her first and get it loose and get all the stagnant blood out of there, then it would be easier for me to get in. But I'm still gonna get that fucker in there. So if you have neck pain, headaches, jaw pain, TMJ, and you've been going to a chiro or doctors and doing all that and you're not better, just come here and let me fix you one time. I know it looks scary, but it's so much better than going to these multiple doctor's appointments, getting injections. I've had clients that they were told they needed surgery and they're fine after coming to me. I'm not saying all this because I want the money. I'm saying all this because I don't want you guys in fucking physical pain when you don't need to be. That's the bottom line. I fucking care. C-A-R-E, I care. She only cried once so far. Right. So yes, I'm going in the traps, and then there are three trigger points here and here, but those I'm gonna get when she's laying down. But I'm gonna show you how to scrape over your upper cervical spine. If you hang in here a few minutes, I'm gonna show you how to scrape all of this. Because a lot of people ask questions, they're afraid to do it, so I'm gonna show you. There we go. That's a big one. That's a big one. That's a big one. And releasing all the tissue will allow the disc to go back in place. Big one. Okay, so now I'm gonna scrape over the cervical spine, you guys. If you wanna watch, if you're in here, I think it'll be great for you to see so that you can understand by loosening the tissue, the disc will go back into place if it is out. All right, somebody pin, I don't have rights to this music, please. Here we go, this is delicate, but it's so important. Do you wanna hold the pillow? You could, and then rest your head on it.
Like this?
Yeah.
My chin or my head?
Your chin. What the fuck are you talking about? Of course your chin.
I don't know.
Hey! Watch your tootishness. Just kidding. So, right over the cervical, there's a lump. A lot of people get a little hard lump in there. I'm gonna oil her up real good. All right, guys, so, I'm gonna go right over it. And you'll see that that lump will disappear. Let me try to put the camera. But it's gonna feel good when I'm done. Okay, I want you guys to really see because there's nothing somebody push pushing on you or anything is not gonna make this better. This is what has got to get done. Give the Muscle Whisperer a chance. Let me fix you. If I can't fix you, if I feel like it's something else, I don't charge you. But I'm telling you guys, it's the body. I'll speak in general. The body needs this. Try it down. I'm going right over the cervical spine. Okay? And I'm going on the side of the spine, up here. And of course I'm gonna be gentle going over the spine itself, but it is pretty well fucking protected. See, I'm getting right up in there. I won't leave you this way. Cause it's wrong when they send you out the door and tell you, I'll see you next. No, they'll see you 3 times a week. Yeah. Give us 3 months and 3 times a week we'll sell you a package. So, you guys can see. And why do people freak out at my bruising, but when they see people with cuppy bruising, it's like, oh, look at that, looks cool. Mine does more work and better for you than those bruisings. Yeah, right there. Right there. Can you guys see that? So I gotta release all that. I haven't scraped this side yet through the chest, and once I do the chest, that'll look better in relief. Yes, you gotta be careful if you're gonna scrape over the spine. You gotta feel confident in what you're doing and not be nervous. I saw this person is like practicing, I don't know, he has like 30 cups on somebody's upper body. Because sucking it isn't going to get it out. That's like a sweep. You need to rake this shit out. And I go gently at the edge of the spine. And I'm going to go gently over here. I'm going to use the corner only. I'm gonna go this way. And the tissue will swell up from my work, but it's gonna be different. Okay, move your head around and neck and see how it feels. It's just, if you're married or you've been in a relationship with somebody for a long time, you have to evaluate. Not just that, you have to evaluate how much is the whole relationship worth. Right? How much is the whole, I'm not advocating like infidelity at all. I'm just acknowledging that I think it's very difficult, and some men have more testosterone than others. Like, we all have testosterone and estrogen, and it's that so. Like, for you saying it's a deal breaker, I get it.
It's not a deal breaker, but I think that if you were under that impression.
Yes, it has to be a discussion. Because I can tell you, when I was married, it was to the point where it was boring. Like, I don't know, so you gotta get some wigs, and it's just something that testosterone And then you tack in everybody's own upbringing and emotional trauma.
Right.
And what they were lacking in from who, it spirals, right? It becomes, I just gotta go here, are you okay?
Yeah.
Feeling better?
Yeah.
Look to her boyfriend, I wouldn't try it though, bro. I wouldn't play with that, bro, because she's serious. Don't try that. I work on a lot of male clients. I've had pro athletes tell me, okay, I'm in a relationship or married or whatever. I go back to my hotel room after the game and there's three beautiful bitches naked in my bed. What the fuck am I supposed to do? I'm like, that's tough. I know. Women are our own worst enemy because we compete against each other, and some don't have boundaries and rules. Like, you just can't do that or this or, you know. Life is about boundaries. Yeah. Sorry. Look, this side's almost done. Yeah. And then I go to the right. Which I've already started.
Oh my god.
Anyway, that's my feeling on it.
I get it.
Yeah.
I think
it's animals too.
We have
do you tell me, like, okay, seriously, so dogs are like, look, that's my bitch over there, nobody touch her. Can be.
Yeah.
Can be. I don't put this under your chin. Yeah, there you go. Can you do that? Because this is the perfect position actually to get where I need to get.
Oh my
god! Yup. Gotta get it, guys. I don't know. What do you all think about it? I think that there's cheating going on and it's just not discussed.
Yeah, and then
you know, as long as I know I'm the top bitch, I'm cool. But the pimps call it the bottom bitch. I just watched a documentary about Iceberg Slim. And he said it. He was like, pimps go and find the girls that you could tell have daddy issues, or didn't get attention, or the right love, or have been abused, and you just have to be nice to them for a day, and then boom, I got control. That's not good. Yes, it is. But there's a lot of people. We are filled with so many different personalities and just like it's crazy. Can't be. I think everything is how we deal with it and how it is. We're given similar situations. How are we going to deal with it? How do we deal with it? Right? We're religious, we believe, we're Jewish, but we also believe in Jesus Christ, and we believe in...
I do, though, essentially.
Yeah. Oh, shit, girl. So right here, y'all, I don't know if you can see it. Yeah, you're gonna feel it in your arm, but... Okay. You'll be fine, I'm saying. I'm having issues. What? No? Yeah, so I got it. She's like, my arm is tingling. That's okay, though. I haven't done the arm yet. I'm just here, so I figure I'm gonna do this. Can you guys see that in her neck? I I'm gonna autograph it. Feel it.
I'm alive.
All right, let's put the pillow down, lay down.